And household budgets dominated discussions as politicians returned to Canberra today. The Albanese government has the votes tonight to pass its safety net bill, meaning a modest increase in welfare payments for Australia's most vulnerable.
Striding into Parliament in a new sitting session facing an age-old question.
Will this Prime Minister admit that Australian families and small businesses are worse off now than when his government was elected?
Cheaper childcare, cheaper medicine, energy bill relief, affordable and social housing, all measures that those opposite opposed.
Tonight, confirmation the job seeker safety net for Australia's most vulnerable is about to grow. The $40 a fortnight increase proposed in the budget will jump to $56 a fortnight through indexation. The Coalition instead want to double what job seekers are able to earn from $150 to $300 a fortnight before their welfare payment is affected. But the government has the numbers in the Senate, meaning the payments will rise from September 20.
Ultimately, if that goes down, as we suspect it will, unfortunately, because I think it's a good policy, then we'll support the government's increase of the $40.
The numbers aren't as clean with the government's signature housing policy, reintroduced to the Parliament this week, but there's no change on the horizon.
You are blocking homes when we want to build homes. Why are you standing in the way of getting more homes on the ground for Australians that need them most?
The Greens have been very clear. You do not have a housing plan if you don't have a plan for the one-third of this country who rents.
Tonight, the Greens want that plan to involve a two-year freeze on rental rates and restrictions moving forward.
What we've said, though, is bottom line, unlimited rent increases need to be illegal.
Something the government says they are unwilling and legally unable to do.
I cannot believe that we are still talking about the housing bill. It actually breaks my bloody heart.
Charles Croucher, Nine News.